smoke on the street from the hamburger stand is hurting her nose and her eyes. Each doorway's a bedroom for Gloria now, and it's there that one day she may die. She sells her papers, but that ain't enough, and she sleeps every night in her clothes. Gloria's out on the street tonight. It's the only life Gloria knows. Drink and she'll dance for the men on her own, or she'll go for a ride in their car. Seats nice and warm when you've stood for so long, and those men aren't so bad before dark. But they never pay much, and their touch is so rough, they say she's no life in her soul. Gloria's out on the street tonight. It's the only life Gloria knows. Street where the shoes from her feet and the wind puts a knife in her arm. She grabs at his throat and refuses a coat from a young man who means her no harm. She'll often chat if the kids will chat back, but most of her time she's alone. Gloria's out on the street tonight. It's the only life Gloria knows. She misses her brother, can't speak to her mother since her own father told her to go. Evening's falling, she thinks about calling, but something inside her says no. So she spends her loose change on a bottle again and drinks it all down in one go. Gloria's out on the street tonight. It's the only life Gloria knows. There'll be trouble in life between a husband and wife. The bad days can bring you right down. But be sure that you know where the little ones go. Always have enough love to go round. Gloria sleeps in a doorway. The wind bites her fingers and toes. Gloria's out on the street tonight. It's the only life Gloria knows. John Clark, who is here again next year, presumably, because everybody said how fabulous he was on their feedback forms last year, so we look forward to that, because he's fab, very funny, despite writing some very serious songs. I think if he'd written that one just before Ralph Mactel wrote Streets of London, that would be the one that everybody was singing, because it's lovely. Right, one slight drawback of this festival weekend, they've got it coinciding with a test match again, and Mike's very fond of his cricket and he just has to keep catching up with the score, and because he's not there listening all the time, they're really not doing very well. So it's entirely his fault. Don't know if anybody heard a score this morning, but I'm sure we'll go and catch up with it later. Anyway, so we're going to do a song about cricket. Actually, more precisely, it's a song about the romance. And some people think this song is just a little bit rude, but it isn't. Rudeness is in the eye of the beholder.
There's no such word.
Isn't there? There is now. Rudeness is in the eye of the beholder. Your cricket mama, and you can be my cricket bloke. Drive me hard through the covers with a well-timed stroke. I don't want no leg glance or no short pitch chat. Just show me how you swing your bat. We'd be some partnership, no one day match. I'd be your wicked maiden and you can be my easy catch. Your leather on my willow would be my reward. I need to get some runs on your board. Well, let's not talk of Sunbridge, cause when they total up our score, I'll be your easy single if you'll be my leg before. We'd know no boundaries, we'd have wickets in hand. I'd even introduce you to the members stand. I don't want no test match, no Sheffield Shield. Just show me how you place your field. With your deep fine leg and your extra point, our runs will never cease. I'm not daring to think about declaring till I've got you in my crease. So when the light is fading or when rain stops playing, I'll be your night watchman any old day. So let's be cricket lovers while the season's here. Come on, let's make it last all year. We can maybe make it last all year. And judging by the sounds, there were some beheeras in here, weren't there? Carney, who's a Lancastrian really, but he's lived in Australia nearly all of his life. That's why it's got all the Australian cricketing symbols in it. So, but he also writes a good thing. He'd be a good one to put down on your thingy list, actually, because he's very good indeed, a phenomenal guitar player.
You're not acting as an agent.
No, I just want them to book all the people I like. It's great, because we've stopped organising a folk festival of our own, so my wish list has to be spread around other people's now. So, anyway, we're going to do a song now, a really serious song. I don't know if you saw on the news quite a few weeks ago now that they unveiled a memorial to Bomber Command, and it had waited donkey's years. And to be honest, I'm not sure I approve of celebrating in that way. The fact that some of ours killed a hell of a lot of theirs, but they decided to do it. But in Lincolnshire, we've got a huge tradition of airfields and bomber squadrons and fighter squadrons and Polish Air Force, and just about everybody who was anybody was in Lincolnshire during the Second World War flying around in aeroplanes. And our local factories, where we live, used to be quite a big industrial area. It isn't now. Where is? And they used to, they had stopped making tractors and things and make munitions, bits of aeroplanes. And the factory managing director of one of the factories, Rosa's, his wife wanted to do her part for the war effort. So she used to invite the airmen in from the aerodromes all over the place to her house on a Sunday, because they couldn't go home to their own mum for Sunday tea. So she used to invite them to come to her house, which was very nice of her. And she made them sign her tablecloth before they went away. And during the week before the next tea party, she embroidered quite badly over the tablecloth. And it's still there. It's in a museum in Gainsborough. And it's a bit of a mess, and it's not quite full. There's some space on it, because the war finished before she'd finished having signatures to fill it. So that's the best bit, really. It's not full.
It's got Guy Gibson.
Guy Gibson, Bomber Harris. Loads of, you can spend ages just looking at names you recognise, especially from your boy's book of knowledge, if you've got one. But this song's about one particular person who was involved. In the early 1940s, when the war was at its height, the factories in Gainsborough made munitions for the fight. The aerodromes were all around, Hemswell, Scampton too, full of all the young men in their uniforms of blue. Mrs. Mrs. Gertrude Rose was like the modern lady left behind. She made them tea and sandwiches and let their nerves unwind. Then they went back to their squadrons to fight the German foe. She stitched their names onto her cloth, a talisman of woe. Woven threads of linen and the stitches neat and small tell the stories of the young men who went away to war. Bomber Harris was a tea-time guest in 1943. He'd seen the new gun turrets made in the factory B. Guy Gibson and the other lads from 617 came with their Lancasters and bouncing bombs as dambusters found fame. Woven threads of linen and the stitches neat and small tell the stories of the young men who went away to war. Flying officer Johnny Johnson didn't go there for his tea. His mother lived in Gainsborough, so it was her he went to see. He aimed the bomb from Enfernut, which breached the Ada Dam. Celebration in the plane, then Gibson's order, head for home. Woven threads of linen and the stitches neat and small tell the stories of the young men who went away to war. When Johnny came back to Gainsborough in 1995, he saw the tablecloth with all the names few still left alive. He took a pen and signed the cloth, a teardrop in his eye. Remembrance of comrades true, so many had to die. Woven threads of linen and the stitches neat and small tell the stories of the young men who went away to war. Johnny actually was at the unveiling of the memorial just a few weeks ago because he's still hanging on in there. Right, this next one's a bit of a risk. Mind you, it all is, isn't it, this time of the morning? Well, it all is a risk if he's standing next to him, actually.